Okay. Have you read the Wall Street Journal opinion on New Zealand's economy versus Australia's economy and their approach to the lockdown?
No, I have not.
Right. So economists expect New Zealand's economy to contract by more than 20% in the 3 months through June, compared with the quarter immediately prior, whereas Australia's economy is expected to shrink some 13%.
And who are these economists making these assumptions? Because I would prefer to listen to Treasury in New Zealand than anyone else.
Are they telling you that our economy won't shrink as much as Australia?
We have scenarios that you will have seen, Mike, that make estimates of impact on GDP and unemployment, and all of them vary depending on how long we stay in the most restricted levels and also how much government investment we have. You will have seen that we have been very, very quick to put investment into our economy to support employers through the wage subsidy, through the business loan scheme, through the guarantee scheme. We have worked alongside the banks to deliver all of that in an effort to cushion the blow to the economy. Right. I would say, Mike, rather than reading the Wall Street Journal, let's see how, in the end, after a few quarters, New Zealand and Australia do relative
sure.
to each other.
Well, ANZ are saying that New Zealand's economy for the year of 2020 will contract 10.4%, Australia's 4.7%. Are they wrong as well?
Well, again, everything's a forecast and an estimate at the moment, Mike. One thing I will say, our wage subsidy got out the door within days of us announcing it prior, and Australia is only, as I understand, just this month getting wage subsidy out. All of those things make a difference.
Are you going to extend the wage subsidy?
It's a 12-week payment. Our view is that we need to be probably more targeted at the point that runs out in June. Keeping in mind it runs till June.
Yeah, and then at that point you'll do what?
At that point there will be businesses who are more likely to be affected on an ongoing basis than others. Of course, the aspiration for June is that everyone, as much as possible, is back up and running. But when you're at, say, for instance, level two, those larger events, conferences, music events, they're all still in a very difficult position because of the restrictions.
So what are you going to do about that?
And so we are looking to target more directly those who are in that category of not being able to operate in the same way they would have at alert level 2.